So these commands may not be in the spotlight anymore, many of which aren't even being used anymore, but they shaped the modern Linux landscape in big ways. Let's uncover these founding father commands. They're like the Mount Rushmore Linux commands, and see how they influence the tools that we rely on now. So first up, let's talk about ifconfig. This is the predecessor to IP. Now, in its heyday, ifconfig or ifconfig was the go-to tool for managing network interfaces. It was released with the early Unix networking stack, and it paved the way for modern networking tools. Obviously, it's now been replaced by IP, which is faster and supports modern protocols like IPv6, but without ifconfig, IP probably wouldn't exist. So ifconfig is one of those founding father commands that, whilst it's deprecated, was definitely the foundation of Linux networking. Next up, we've got netstat. This is like the grandparent of the SS command, and netstat was a powerful tool for examining network connections, sockets, and routing tables. Now, obviously, this inspired tools like SS, which are now fast enough for more detailed output for modern networking. But overall, netstat is the wise old grandparent of today's network monitoring tools. We also have the original text editor, ED. This was the first text editor on Unix systems, and it introduced concepts like line editing and influenced tools like VI and Nano. And it's barely used today, but its DNA is in every modern editor. And if you've ever used them, you owe a debt of gratitude to Ed, because though I wouldn't recommend trying to edit files with it now, it is where everything began. Now, if you've ever used SCP, are you aware of its predecessor, RCP? This is one of the first tools for transferring files over a network. Its limitations and lack of security led to the creation of SCP, of course, for secure copying. And that obviously introduced encryption and reliability, which we all depend upon. But RCP was incredibly helpful, and without it, we wouldn't have the secure tools that we rely on today, like SCP or even rsync for backing up and syncing files, of course. Now let's talk about FSCK. This is the foundation of file system maintenance. It was critical for checking and repairing file systems in the early days of Linux to ensure system stability. And whilst its functionality has evolved into modern tools like E2 FSCK, its core principles remain essentials. Now, while rarely needed on modern systems, it did lay the groundwork for file system integrity checks. So it's again one of those founding fathers and belongs in the Mount Rushmore of Linux commands. Now let's talk about the original chat app. Yep, that's the talk command. This allowed real-time text-based communication between users on the same system or network. It was a revolutionary concept back in the 1980s. We take it for granted today, but honestly, this was massive. And its legacy lives on in modern messaging tools. Though obviously, it's now practically unused today, apart from maybe some Linux aficionados who still enjoy using commands like talk. Now, talk, for me, is a piece of history that reminds us just how far communication tools have come, and it definitely belongs in the founding fathers of Linux commands. Back to more networking, we've got Traceroute, which was an early network diagnostics tool. This is one of the first tools for diagnosing network paths and identifying bottlenecks. Modern tools like MTR have expanded on its capabilities with real-time updates and better performance. However, and whilst it's while not reliable today due to firewalls, Traceroute was groundbreaking in its time and one of those early networking tools that was so important. So again, definitely belongs on this list of founding father Linux command tools. When it comes to user monitoring, one of the earliest commands has to be who. This showed which users were logged into the system and laid the groundwork for commands like w and uptime. And it's simple, but its concept influenced modern system monitoring tools. Now, to me, this is a classic that's still hanging on. And though it's been surpassed by some more comprehensive tools, and depending on what you do with your Linux system admin, maybe you do or don't use who, but who is one of those commands that has a soft spot in my heart. It's one of those early Linux commands, so it definitely belongs on this list. And it definitely laid the groundwork for a lot of modern processes and tools today. Now, this is a command that is still being used every day. Of course, it's chmod or chmod. It's pioneered permission control, and it's one of the first tools to implement Unix permission model using octal notation to control file access. The concept of permissions that it introduced remains fundamental to Linux security. And for me, even decades later, it hasn't been replaced, and that's a testament to its foundational design and how it's long-lasting and here to stay. This is the one command on the list that I am saying is a founding father, so to speak, of the Linux command line tools, but really, it is the one that has outlasted the rest because we still use it all the time. There is no better use for changing file permissions than chmod. So it is still here, live and large, and one of the best tools, and one of the OG tools, you could say, of Linux command line. So let's wrap up with the precursor to SSH, and that is Telnet. Now, for me, Telnet is really nostalgic. It's the original tool for remote access, predating SSH by many years, but its lack of encryption highlighted the need for secure alternatives like SSH. Now, Telnet's flaws obviously gave rise to secure connections, but it was one of the most significant stepping stones in Linux history. And if you like hacker culture, 90s hacker movies, and 90s hacker style culture, Telnet is one of the parts of that. If you've ever seen the movie Hackers, they were using Telnet. It's fantastic. I love Telnet. Obviously, we don't use it anymore, but it is an important tool to point out, and it is one of those commands that definitely laid the groundwork for the modern secure networking commands that we use today for connections like SSH. So definitely deserves its spot and the final spot on this list. So there you have it. The 10 Linux commands laid the foundation for the tools that we use today. And while many of them have been replaced or fallen out of common use, the impact on Linux is undeniable. If you've enjoyed the trip to memory lane, hope you enjoyed this with me, and I can't wait to see you in the next video. And as always, thanks for watching.